The bumphead parrotfish was once found across a huge range of the Indo-Pacific region. East Africa to French Polynesia, and from Japan to Australia. Reaching 1.3 meters long and over 50 kilograms in weight, they are the largest of the parrotfish. Huge herds would graze upon the hard corals and algae, pulverizing them to excrete as sand. They perform a key ecological role within a healthy coral reef ecosystem, but due to their large size and good meat, they have also been heavily fished, and now their range is much reduced. One area where they can still be found is the Republic of Palau, an island nation located 500 miles east of the Philippines. Here, the bumphead parrotfish has always played an important role in traditional culture. Typically caught by speargun, the fish was a regular occurrence on the menu at cultural events such as this first birth ceremony. During the 1980s, investment was made in Palau's fishing industry. New gear and ice plants were acquired to provide revenue for local communities. However, after a few years, the market became saturated with fish, prices dropped, and fishermen started to notice less fish on the reefs.
Well, it was probably the first time where the fishermen of Palau sort of put regulations for themselves. So it was a very, very kind of a far ahead of its time, but the difficulty was enforcement. We know that maybe enforcement will come later, so we knew that the enforcement was a problem. And so we saw that while it was doing a lot of good work for many, many other species and others, we saw that the enforcement was not strong enough, and we continued to see the decline in that particular fish. And so that's why we began to think about the greater protection. So we set aside certain areas also sanctuaries for fish. And we also, in addition, because we perceived that it continued to decline, back in, I believe, 2004, while I was in Congress, we put a total ban on taking that particular species.
The moratorium imposed by the Marine Protection Act of 2004 allowed populations to slowly recover. During this time, Palau was fast gaining a reputation as a world-class dive destination, with many Palauans benefiting from the increased tourist dollars. In recent years, traditional fishermen, many of whom are also regular divers, started to notice more and more fish on the reefs, with some divers noticing large aggregations occurring at certain times. This interest continued to develop, with certain dive companies working out precisely what was going on at what turned out to be spawning aggregations. This understanding of the spawning cycle has enabled these dive shops to offer it as a special event to discerning scuba tourists looking for new and unique adventures. This aggregation discovery has had another effect. Fishermen and local restaurateurs now increasingly feel that there are enough bumphead parrotfish to support at least a low-level harvest. This growing pressure on the bumpheads led to a population census being commissioned by Palau's Bureau of Marine Resources. The study was carried out by Palau's International Coral Reef Center and the University of Hawaii. 80 sites around Palau were picked at random, with researchers doing timed swims, counting fish numbers to estimate the population. The study's findings were presented to Palau's Congress in September 2013.
However, from what I'm hearing from the Congress, I think it's also the recommendation that there's additional market survey that's needed to be done in order for us to really come up with a good management scheme to enable us to sustainably manage this really important resource. They were not very keen on opening it up again. In fact, they were very willing to wait for the full study to be completed before we make a more informed decision on how we move forward.
These feelings were also echoed by Palau's traditional leaders.
I suggested this to the Congress. Let's hold on to this, you know. And let's have, right now we have a knowledge, science knowledge. Let's have an extensive study on that. The growth of the fish in our number of consumption. And also let's look at our the culture. Okay. Because if you open it right now, you know, everybody uses scuba tank. The fish will be gone in a matter of time. And I'm afraid of that. So I like to hold everything and have extensive study to them. And after we complete our study, should we have, there is a season open, how long the season going to be open? And that's going to be all depends on how many fish we get. So we're going to have to have a program to monitor the fishing program. And when we have that, I think we can formulate the program to how we control this. At the same time, how we're going to merge that traditions into it. So we have that significant of that fish.
The bumphead parrotfish has found sanctuary, thanks to scientists and legislators working together in the Republic of Palau.